Do you like stories? I do. Stories about adventures, action, magic, love. Stories that are make-believe. Stories that are true. Stories that sometimes take the truth and bend it. Stories about spiders, witches, creepy houses. I'd like to share my story with you. Are you sitting comfortably? Now, although I can't guarantee its authenticity, I'll begin. It was October.
No, maybe it was November. No. I remember! This story happened right between.
Between?
Yes.
But...
Oh! Halloween! When the clock strikes 12, and it's neither nor. When the living and the dead are both either or. When the 12th bell tolls, and time stands still. When midnight magic happens in the house on the hill. Some stories start with once upon a time. Too many, perhaps.
Yes.
But not mine. You see, I had a necklace. One that I'd found. A shiny pearl hung from the chain I wore round my neck. Every day was a rustic loop, so delicately sparkling, it looked like a troop of stars. It looked great on. Anyway, where were we? Ah, yes, well, last Halloween, I suddenly noticed my necklace had gone! When I placed my small hand around my neck, it had just disappeared! Oh dear! Oh heck! Turning green, I couldn't believe this! Why, who would be so sneaky and cheeky and devious? And just when I thought, how could this be? I spied from my eye a letter just for me. I opened it quickly and on it read,
"If you want to see your necklace again, you'd best come to the house on the hill. When the clock strikes 12, you'll see a big door. Knock 3 times, and there you will find out more."
Thinking about what the letter had said, I set off down the lumpy, bumpy road, counting the pumpkins. 1, 2, 3, 4, and stepping on toads. To the house on the hill, where the stone gargoyle sat. I opened the gate. A rat-a-tat. As I waited, a gargoyle came to life. A bat and a frog and his princess wife. I went to knock 3 times on the door when the gargoyle growled,
"No, no, no more. There's a password, young lady, you'll have to crack before you think of entering that. You've got 3 guesses at solving this up there. You can see the letters flying round in the air. Figure the word out and do it correctly. Then deliver the answer to me directly. Get it right, you can pass unknown. Get it wrong, and you're turned to stone. Here is your clue. Now, it's over to you.
Oh no! A password? I don't want to turn to stone. Can anyone help me? I can't do it alone. My first guess is pumpkin.
No, pumpkin is wrong.
Oh. My second guess is munchkin.
No, munchkin is wrong. You have one more chance.
Halloween!
Oh dear, oh brat! Oh, all things obscene! How did you guess? You must have had help!
And with that, the gargoyle gave a yelp!
No!
A werewolf howled to a scattered moon! And the door opened wide! Eerie first room. I walked down the hall into the room on the right. The door was painted a blood-stained white. It looked like a kitchen, but it was in a complete state. There can't have even been one clean plate. There were bits on the floor, weird things in jars. Labels for pickled bear's paw. Milk bottles that said they were from Mars. A sink full of brown mold. Snake's skin. Pig's liver. Garlic mice. Where had these been sold? Not from any shop I'd been to. Then, I heard a scuffling. When I turned, I realised it couldn't have been you. Again, there was a muffled shuffling. Then, from the peeling ceiling, a hairy spider dropped in, hanging from a web as thin as a pin.
You look very tasty, even with your pasty skin. Maybe I'll cook you with cow bread or some squirrel I caught down the lane. I'd have a Michelin star, but I'm struggling with the decor. I haven't got any tables or a bar.
Well, you won't have a great rapport with the customers if you say you'll eat them. I thought I'd better interject before I was condemned.
Well, before we proceed, I need your help. If you don't want me to stew you with cabbage and kelp, tell me, young girl, if you're able to help me build some wonderful tables. You see, I've been thinking, if only with a few tables, I'm bound to get business. What do you think? I'll scratch your back. If you scratch mine.
And if I don't, you'll eat me. Okay, oh fine. Now, let's see. Build tables. Well, there isn't any wood, or metal, or plastic. Oh no, this is no good. in a kitchen that belongs to a spider. I've got it! I know a great provider of material suitable to hold a spidey cuisine. Your web! It's strong and long and clean. Why, it would make a perfect table for spider's guests. Spider, I've got it. Give me some of your web. Now, I'm going to need some help. Who will be the table legs?
Fantastique, très bon, très joli. J'adore la table. My restaurant is complete. Now would you take care to join me in a spidery feast of flies and maggots? Ah well, bon appetit. Now if you come and sit at my new dining table, I'll tell you, child, of an interesting fable. You see, young girl, only yesterday, I saw a cat. She was black, with deep green eyes. A necklace in her paws. She tried to sell me. But since I have no neck, what use would this be?
Stop! Stop there! A necklace, you say?
Yes, the pearl on a rusty chain.
And where did she go, this slinky cat?
Well, I think up the stairs. Yes, probably that.
Okay, now I helped you build your tables, so can you help me?
Okay, since you built my table so beautifully.
Why do you think she wanted my necklace?
Who knows, maybe she is just reckless.
Oh, Spider, that answer was useless.
Ah, mon petit, you are proving to be a nuisance. Now, get out of my restaurant. You've been here long enough. Follow the staircase. There you will find old McGruff. He will know where the cat went. Tell him Spidey sent you with love from me. And good luck, young child, on your journey.
Bon voyage, monsieur.
Au revoir. Merci.
And off I went to find the stairs where Spidey had sent me. Calling McGruff's name, trying very politely to figure out just who this McGruff character was. I whispered intently, Spidey sends his love. McGruff, McGruff, Spidey sends his love. An armored knight rattled and rattled again. For a moment I thought, perhaps that was him. But when I touched it, it suddenly collapsed to the floor. Not McGruff. Oh, I'll have to look some more. I took one step and the staircase creaked. With a jump, I gasped and felt a gooey green leak drop on my head. Then it occurred to me, maybe McGruff is dead. A ghost on the stairs. He jumped out of the wall with a jolly old laugh. He gave me a fright that made me fall. McGruff, is that you?
Why, of course, who else? You look as white as a sheet. Have you seen yourself? Anyone would think you've seen a wee ghost. Oh, I forget you have. Well, here's a toast to the living and the dead and all that's between. Now, what can I do for you? It is Halloween.
Yes, I know, and I'm sorry to trouble you. You seem like a friendly sort of person to me.
Well, yes, but I can tell you, nothing comes for free. Not in this house, I'm afraid, my dear. And you smell of flesh and blood. Oh, that smell. It does smell good.
Well, I received a letter telling me to come here. Now I'm looking for a cat. I don't suppose you've seen her.
Ah, that'll be Tess, our dear feline. Go on then. What has she done this time?
She's taken my necklace under witch's orders.
Ah, both of them are total hoarders.
I need to know which way she went.
And I shall tell you, but a wee price will be spent.
Go on, McGruff, what's the cost this time?
Well, you as a human, you have feelings in your fingers. Something as ghosts fail to linger onto. I haven't felt for 150 years. But if you could just help me, tell me, what does this pumpkin feel like? Can you help me?
It feels like... Oh!
And what does this spider's web feel like? What does this goo feel like? And I want to know, what does this chocolate taste like? Oh, what a great description. It felt like I could feel and taste those things. Watch out, Ivy. I'm not sure what the future will bring. For you, young child, I'd watch your back. That witch, she's got a funny knack of tricking you humans to doing her bidding.
I'm not scared, I said, but I knew I was fibbing.
Thank you for helping me, Ivy, my friend. And you want to know where the cat was last seen? Turn left to the landing. Be quiet. Don't scream. You don't want to scare her. She's a feisty beast. But there you will find her. Purring, at least.
Thank you, McGruff. You were great fun. And if you enjoy eating a tasty treat, I can recommend a great place to eat. Spidey's restaurant, just down the stairs. There's great food and drinks, and tables and chairs.
And so I continued, through the creepy house, down across the landing, where the cat chased a mouse. "Meow," she said with a sudden shock.
"We've been expecting you. Now, before you can knock onto the witch's bedroom door and find out what she wanted your necklace for, you must work out these three pesky riddles. There's 1 and 3 and 2 in the middle. The first one, I am the home in the night, the ever watchful eye. I return in a circle to enlighten the sky. What am I?"
"Can anyone help me?" "Oh, I know, it's the moon."
"Okay, and moving on. I have 100 legs, but I cannot stand. I have a long neck, but no head. I ease the witch's life
so she can fly through the sky. What am I?
Oh no, what do you think it is? Oh, 100 legs, the broom.
Yes, you are right. And finally, stealthy as a shadow in the dead of night. Cunning but affectionate, if given the bite. Never owned but often loved, and at my sport considered cruel. But that's because you never know me at all. What am I?
What could that be? It's you! A cat! The door swung open and in I went. The clock ticked 12 and I saw the cauldron. The witch stood there, my necklace dangling, bubbling, slowly hanging, swinging backwards and forwards, and cackling laughter filled the room. The broom sweeping and the pumpkin weeping.
Did you know this necklace has powers? Look, little Ivy, I can turn rabbits to flowers.
I knew it! I screamed. I'd known all along. She'd stolen my necklace. To do so much wrong. She wanted it, you see, to do evil things. To turn birds to bats and to sever their wings. To control the world and all its people. To be the queen of Halloween. I had come all the way here to collect my necklace. And I wasn't going to leave without it. And allow the witch to rule about. I'm no normal human child. In fact, the reality is I'm pretty wild. I also have magical powers, you see. And I snapped my fingers, and the necklace flew into my hand. And with a flash of lightning, the witch turned to sand. What a nasty old witch, stealing things from others. She's giving us all a bad name. But I know this trick wasn't in vain. Because now I'm the witch of the creepy house. But I'm going to be good. I'm going to denounce all the horrible things witches are known for. And throw a Halloween party. Just for you. So come on into my creepy house. Bring all your friends, whether cat or mouse.
I've got the music,
said McGruff.
I've got the moves, said Tess.
I've got the food,
said Spidey.
Hooray,
said the gargoyle. Let's have a party!
For my monster from his slab began to rise. And suddenly, to my surprise,
he did the mash.
He did the monster mash.
The monster mash.
It was a graveyard smash.
He did the mash.
It caught on in a flash.
He did the mash.
He did the monster mash. Wow. From my laboratory in the castle east, wow, to the master bedroom where the vampires. The ghouls all came from their humble abodes to get a jolt from my electrode.
They did the mash.
They did the monster mash.
The monster mash.
It was a graveyard smash.
They did the mash.
It caught on in a flash.
They did the mash.
They did the monster mash. The zombies were having fun.
In a soup
the party had just begun. guest included Wolfman, Dracula and his son. The scene was rocking, all were digging the sounds. Igor on chains, backed by his baying hounds. The coffin bangers were about to arrive with their vocal group, the Crypt Kicker Five.
They played the mash.
They played the monster mash.
The monster mash.
It was a graveyard smash.
They played the mash.
It caught on in a flash.
They played the mash.
They played the monster mash. Out from his coffin, Rack's voice did ring. Seemed he was troubled by just one thing. Opened the lid and shook his fist and said, whatever happened to my Transylvania twist?
It's now the mash.
It's now the monster mash.
The monster mash.
And it's a graveyard smash.
It's now the mash.
It's caught on in a flash.
It's now the mash.
It's now the monster mash. Now everything's cool, Drax a part of the band, and my monster mash is the hit of the land. For you, the living, this mash was meant to. When you get to my door, tell them what is said.
Then you can mash.
Then you can monster mash.
The monster mash.
And you, my graveyard smash.
Then you can mash.
You'll catch on in a flash.
Then you can mash.
Then you can monster mash.